Three lives, three feeds, three stories. A viral cocktail of soaring unemployment, COVID lockdowns, and a hungry online audience gave three Ghanaian content creators their start.
No job.
We go behind the filters to find out the highs and lows of making money online.
I've been eating a sausage.
God, I know I'm about to sing.
In 2020, the Chinese-owned short video platform TikTok became the world's most downloaded app with 1 billion active users worldwide. One of those users is a young woman from a small town in southern Ghana.
My name is Martina Dramina, popularly known as Asantewa. I am a nurse, a TikToker, an actress, an entrepreneur, and every good thing you can think of. So the very first video I uploaded was during the COVID era where everybody was supposed to stay indoors.
I told me come my boyfriend.
What did you say?
I told me 17.
The 28-year-old, known by her 2.3 million followers as Asantewa, has since become one of Ghana's most followed TikTokers.
I don't mind using the whole day to shoot a 5-second video just to get it perfect.
Omo, Ma? What do you want to be in future?
Oga wife.
You say?
Oga wife.
Wearing a dress can pay off. Eating can pay off. I mean, just doing this can't even pay off. Yeah.
TikTok has identified Africa as a key growth market. With its young population and better broadband speed, millions more Africans are using TikTok daily, and many businesses on the continent have begun partnering with influencers to promote their brands.
TikTok doesn't pay directly here in Africa, specifically Ghana. We do not get paid directly from the app. You can just promote a brand's business for the brand to pay you.
So you can teach us unboxing something from Techno. This design is limited. This is actually the Techno Come On 19 Pro Mandron.
Today we have here the Mlere Lemonade and the Rosella. Yay!
In the past decade, Ghana's youth unemployment rate has almost tripled, reaching an all-time high of 13.4% in 2022.
Living in Ghana with no job, it's very frustrating. You have to eat. Food is not cheap in Ghana. So you have to work. And we don't have the jobs. So if there is any small way an individual can create his or her own space to work, that is a big wow for the person. I completed school, had to sacrifice my 2-3 years to be able to raise some money for my little brother to also complete school. Then I got help and I was able to pursue my nursing.
Before she found fame, Asantewa got a job working as a nurse at Ngleshi Amanfro Health Center. In Ghana, an average nursing salary is £170 a month. Her rapid online success meant she could leave nursing, but she still practices.
I can never trade nursing for anything. I love it. And that is why I am practicing.
Asantewa is one of the lucky ones in more ways than one. For many in Ghana, finding work is a challenge.
So for those of you who don't understand Chi, this lady is lamenting over the fact that they've completed the nursing training school. And for some time now, they've not been posted.
My name is Bernard Kojo Amoafu. That's my real name, but popularly known as Kojo Sheldon.
The Sheldon came from the Big Bang Theory.
Welcome to this episode of Yaha of the Day.
I know you have an appointment after this.
Because, bro, it's crazy.
I'm a digital content creator in Ghana, and I've been doing this for the past 4 years.
Kojo Sheldon's profile skyrocketed during the COVID lockdowns. Now, 850,000 followers stream to his platforms to hear his balanced and humorous takes on the day's trending topics.
Work on National Cathedral Project suspended over inadequate funds. This is God telling us that as a country, we should expand our hospitals. We should invest in beds. We should invest in our education. We should invest in road infrastructure. We should do all these things where it be important.
You know, cost of living in this country is on an all-time high.
When you get hungry, the government is not going to feed you. When you can't get money to pay for your child's school fees, the government is not going to feed you.
So they come into your comment section and vent. People don't even have money to buy food to eat, but they will get data to come and watch my video.
Raised by his grandmother in a farming community in the eastern region of the country, the daily struggle to make ends meet is something Sheldon can relate to.
Hey, my ba.
Wow.
My ba.
Now, where your body says, sir?
Oh, about you send the unse, my pump, and move. Ain't see, and then I am in this. Oh, we weren't rich. My grandma was a farmer. Sometimes I have to wake up before you go to school, because it's not every day that she's going to have the money for you or give you money to go to school. Because if she doesn't have the money, you can't do anything about it. So I have to go the extra mile to hustle for myself.
Social media has given Kojo a platform and steady income, but it does come at a price.
There is always that instance that you are going to be mentally not okay. And I have experienced it on several occasions. I'm not going to lie. There are instances that you feel like you have hit rock bottom, like there is nothing for you at the end of the tunnel. You are always trying to please your audience, trying to create content they want, trying not to step on someone's toe in the course of your work. There are instances that like people even threaten you. This kind of environment is so volatile, it's sensationalized to the point that if you are not mentally strong or fortified, it will get to a point where like you wouldn't be able to do this. I'm not going to sit here and lie that I don't go through that kind of emotional roller coaster.
Social media can be a fickle arena, but for many, it's also a way out.
I don't want to be another unemployment statistic. Oh, I'm depending on the government. I feel like at this point, that I have this kind of mindset that the day I stop, everything is going to go south. You understand? So I wake up, I don't go on vacation. I don't do anything. It's just work, putting in the work, because I'm afraid to fail. The swimming pool, about 1,000 people are in the swimming pool. I should say by the people urinated in the pool, but it is all part of the game, you understand? We started from this room as using a phone. We transitioned to having the whole house to ourselves to create content. So I was dedicated. But you don't make money straight away from YouTube. You have to build the audience.
Kojo now has 5 million people watching his YouTube monthly. Along with his audience, his income is growing too.
Ooh, this is nice.
YouTube's partner program allows creators to monetize their content through ad revenues, channel memberships, and merchandising.
Everything is here. This is the most important part of the back end. So we have 3.2 million views. We've earned an estimated revenue of $11,234.74.
Now, this episode of Yaha of the Day is brought to you by TapTapSend. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel.
So we started with $500, $100, the $200. Then the more we created, the more we had like a lot of revenues coming in for us. So at some point, then we crossed the $1,000 threshold. Then we started making decent money. $1,000 will look small if you don't convert it, but when I convert it to my currency, I'm rich, very, very rich.
You can do that, you can do it.
Okay, let's play a day match.
Every day online, there are new addictive ways of making money. One of the latest is live gifting. If you have a minimum of 1,000 followers, you could be making money through the game launched by TikTok in 2021. In 4 minutes, two players compete to attract virtual gifts from their followers, awarding their content.
Today I'm gifting you auto.
The gifts are bought with real money. Roses, the cheapest gift, cost a few cents. Corgis are around $5. Lions and universes are the biggest gifts and are worth around $500 each. At the end of the game, the winner can cash out their haul through PayPal. This feature appeals to popular influencers as well as regular users.
I mean, it's expensive to buy these coins to gift. And because it's expensive, when you throw, for example, a lion, which is 30,000, everyone else is looking up to you. So they've become some sort of demigod in the space, you know.
They worship you.
Yes,
yeah,
absolutely.
They worship you like you are God.
Yeah. Web developer Pakwesi Adapo, known to his followers as Asaji4, has built up a reputation as a generous gifter.
I was here by myself for quite a bit, lonely. It was a support mechanism after COVID and trying to recover. And I found some real friends who I could vibe with every evening on the app. And also that's how I started gifting.
Even TikTok are taking like 70%. So what would the rose do to the person?
Yeah.
That 70% figure Anita's talking about is one of the game's biggest catches. Players in Ghana say that TikTok takes a 70% cut of all winnings.
If I bought 30,000 coins, which can gift a lion, it will cost me, say, £450 in this region. And the receiver only gets about £150 for it.
We asked TikTok to confirm their revenue. They said, it is incorrect to say TikTok receives 70% of live gift revenues directly. We asked them to confirm their commission, exchange, and admin fees. They said, we don't share publicly details on TikTok's earnings from creator monetization features. TikTok refused to confirm their rates, but one thing is clear. In Ghana, those on the receiving end only see around 30% of their own winnings.
So that whole game aspect of it has made it really toxic. Whereas before, it was just a live space to come and engage with your audience. So that game thing is introducing gambling to the space. It's affecting people's well-being psychologically. And I think it needs to be addressed. There has to be some sort of ombudsman to regulate that part of things. For some strange reason, we've all gotten very addicted to it and we cannot stop. Be it a giver or a receiver, we are on there all the time. You'll be amazed how many people are sitting there 24/7 just playing games all day long, and how many people are feel obliged to just recharge the account. Oh no, let's work again. So I might just lose. We have people who gift big, and when they gift big, everybody sees them and everybody wants to be like them.
Six, five, four, go.
Boom. That in itself really brings toxicity to the app. Because you see these people throwing this huge gift, like 30,000, 100,000 universes. And you think, oh my God, I want to be this person. And yet you don't know the source of their income, right? And they're throwing these things and you feel like you want to do the same thing. So you might end up going to do something that you're not supposed to do just to become one of these big guys.
I've got a frozen screen, which means he's going
to
win.
Advice I give to newbies is try not to get pressured into gifting.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Please don't try and empty your bank account just to get famous on this app.
Besides the money, the game's interactivity really appeals, and even those with huge followings like Asantua are hooked.
So you see the lion roar like, whoa, on the whole screen of the phone. And that is so huge. If
me, the dancer, I receive the gifts. I'm like, this is so expensive. Let me give you some extra moves. Do you get? Then, so you're just communicating with your people. It's a vibe.
In any game, there are winners and losers. With 60% of Ghana's population under the age of 25, many more young people are getting online and trying their hand. Asantewa, Shelding, and Osagyefor are in the minority, breaking through and finding a new path in this ever-evolving but slimly regulated space.
We are quite Siapa. When did I say that?